Octopush. My name's Alex Towles. I am joined by Noah. Hello, Noah.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the game of Octopush.
So we are live on audio only on Roses Live. We are also live on the TV on Roses Live. We should be good to go in a couple of minutes. Noah, you know a lot more about the game of Octopush than I do. Can you give me a brief, very brief rundown of what we're about to see?
So this is a really, really new sport, but actually it was invented in 1954.
Okay.
And invented by British people, a couple of like diving club players. They just invented this game, and nowadays more and more universities in England or in the UK, they have the underwater hockey society, which is Octopush.
Yes.
And we can see there are like two sides of the pool, and they go from each end to the other side. And now we can see
the
game is already officially starting.
So, it's underwater hockey, as you say. Octopush is the name that we're calling it on the website. It's another,
it's more like a professional way to say that.
The joint official name. It's played in the deep end of the pool.
Yes.
So it's probably difficult to see on the cameras, but there is a row of pucks along halfway down the pool, marking the touchline.
And we can see they have like a big competition in the near end, which is the York side.
Yes, so what we should probably state that Lancaster are in the blue hats and York are in the white. And it looks like, was that a Lancaster goal?
I'm not sure about that because I was focusing on the competition. You know,
well, they seem to be swimming back, and it was a big mess over on the York side.
So
and
I
Lancaster
guess
swimming back,
it should so be a goal, yes. And they're subbing now, and we can see.
They're rolling subs, like will everyone just be subbing continuously?
So people with specific position will like sub with each other.
Okay.
Oh, so this is another round, and we can see who will get the puck first.
So they've got fins on. They've also got a, would you call it a stick? Does it have a fancy
it's
name?
It's like a bat, let's say.
A bat in their right hands, most of them.
So
it's kind of like a very, very short
Very short
stick.
Version, yes.
Yeah, so it's like, and they're trying to push the ball around, the puck around with that.
Yes, we can see there's another goal, should be.
And there has been another goal for Lancaster. Lancaster running away with it early doors.
Actually, early this year we have the Students' Nationals, and we witnessed very excellent players from the York side, and we think the game will be very competitive.
Okay.
So, yeah, we can see there are already two goals approximately.
Mm-hmm. How long will the game be? What length has it been?
So the first part will be 15, and also the second part 15, so in total 30 minutes. And between the two parts, there will be about 3 minutes to have a break and talking about some, you know, strategic issues.
Amazing.
Yeah, let's see.
So what kinds of strategy would you tend to see in the Octopush?
So
as Lancaster charge forward again?
So it's very similar to the football. As you can see, we have the forward. So we have to select very strong forward to make sure that they can swing fast enough to get the puck first.
Amazing.
And secondly, we have the middle field, which is like the wing and the center. So center is more like connecting to each part of the players, and we need to have a strong defense in the middle field, and also they have the ability to pass the puck to the attacker.
And it looks like we're restarting the game once again. We've got the referee over on the far side from where we're looking, over on the left-hand side, and the referee will start the game. They will run towards the middle. Lancaster will get the puck, and Lancaster will score if it follows the pattern of the rest of the game so far.
Usually, who take the spot, take the puck first, will get the advantage. But let's see. We can see there's a mess in the middle, and Lancaster now is holding the puck, and York players are trying to defend around the goal. And obviously, York players.
It looks like they got the puck away somewhat. It's now a maelstrom in the middle of the park.
They're trying to put the puck into the side. Okay, so we can see the park is around York site again and again. Seems like we have another goal for Lancaster.
Right, so it's now 4-0 to Lancaster, I believe. Is that right?
Oh, wow. That's
impressive. Is that how many goals we've seen?
I think so. And yeah, as we can see, we can see like Lancaster players spend a lot of time in the York side, which means the attack is very successful. Mm-hmm. And somehow York is now in a passive like situation. Mm. They are tired of like defending. But hopefully when we see if they can have some change, having some more powerful forward and to get the puck. But unfortunately, I can see Lancaster players get the puck again.
Yeah, well, Lancaster are looking very strong. Obviously, last year, we were unfortunate not to be able to see the Octopush at Roses 2022. York had to forfeit as they were unable to field a team. They're fielding a team this year, but Lancaster are blasting through them.
We have very big society this year, and for some tournaments, we can even send two teams. So we have very regular training sessions, and we have the extra training sessions outside the university.
So Lancaster are a very, very big Octopush university there.
And also, yes, we also have some very experienced players in the team currently. Mm-hmm. And they are not only playing in the UK, but also like playing in like Ireland and like all over the world. So as we can see, it's kind of the advantages they have. But again, the Roses is one of the biggest game in the year, so those advantage taken from the players, they just bring them all to the arena.
Yeah, and your national standard players do seem to be very, very up for it today as Lancaster go on the attack once more. Is that another goal for Lancaster? It seems to be a bit of a scrum going on down under the water.
I think there's a goal.
I think that was a goal. Is it a goal every time the opposition team goes back to the start?
Yes, yes. Okay. You have to go back to your side, and the referee will put the puck into the middle side again. Mm-hmm. And you don't have time to, you know, take a break.
No, yeah.
So basically, the one who just get the goal, they have the disadvantage because they are very tired. They have to swim back to the side, but again, they have to start very like immediately.
So that is 4-5 to Lancaster.
I think it's like 5 or 6-0.
5 to Lancaster.
Oh wow, very impressive for Lancaster players.
Mm. A very, very impressive early doors performance from Lancaster here.
Yes. Oh, that's a very nice flip from, I think it's Joe from Lancaster. It has a very nice flip. They just pushed the puck in a very strategic way, and the puck just jumped, passing through the York defenders and directly going to the goal.
Oh, wow. So that's a quite difficult skill to pull off.
Yes, and especially when somebody is like facing you, mm-hmm. and you don't think you can do some other techniques such as like curlings, or if you're really close to the goal, you just need to use all your power, all your energy to flip that puck, and the puck will jump.
Amazing. So what can you, as we see the Lancaster and York teams dive down to fetch the puck again.
Yes, and there are some fight in the middle.
Yeah, York seems to be bringing the puck forward. Yes, stolen well by Lancaster.
They just stole it very immediately from the York player. Mm. They're still trying their best to defend. But it seems like we have two very powerful forwards to be like a group.
Yes.
One is being like defended, and another one is like giving them like a sign language, maybe underwater, I can't see. Maybe just a hand to tell them to pass. And if there's no one looking at that player, it will be a goal. Very, very successful strategy.
So one of the big differences with Octopush compared to, say, field hockey is that you've got this third dimension. You're not just defending in front of or behind your opposition. You've got to be aware of what's on top of you as well.
Sometimes people are floating, but when they see the puck, they will immediately dive into the pool.
So how difficult is it to defend from somebody who's diving down from on top of you to try and get the puck?
Well, it depends. Sometimes if you are moving very fast, actually, if you just dive in directly, it's very difficult to catch them. But some defenders, they are waiting for their teammates to coming up and get the puck. And at this moment, I think it is a good opportunity to dive into the pool and to have a fight with the one having the puck. But so far we can see Lancaster players are more organized. They know how strong their forwards are and which direction they should go for the puck. And if York is trying to stop it, let's see this round. Okay.
So do the players go back to their sides any other times other than when a goal is scored? Or can we take the players going back to their respective sides as a surefire sign that a goal has happened?
So for most of the time, it only happened when there's a goal. But sometimes if you want to sub,
okay,
you have to swim back and to call somebody to jump into the pool. But usually we don't do that if we are attacking.
Mm-hmm.
Usually only the people who are defending, because you are close to your teammates when you are doing the defending thing.
Mm-hmm.
They will ask, it's like, okay, I need to jump out of the pool and someone just jump in. And you have to touch the side and go to continue the game. And
is this is Octopush a game with a continuously running clock, or does the clock stop every time there's a stoppage in play?
What do you mean stop?
So for example, in football, when the ball goes out for a throw-in, we are live now on the Roses main feed. Welcome to Octopush, or underwater hockey. And I'm Alex Towers. I'm joined by Noah. And we are watching what appears to be a Lancaster rout.
Yes.
It seems to be 6-0 or 7-0 to Lancaster,
okay,
as Lancaster score again.
Yes.
I believe that is 8 for Lancaster.
Yes.
We are roughly 10 minutes into this first half, and Lancaster have scored 8 already.
So let's
Roses, the score was 14-2. So Lancaster have already scored 8 goals, which is nearly as many as they did last time this game was played at Roses back in 2018.
So, yeah, I mean, that's very impressive. And because we don't have many opportunities in a year to play against York, so we have to learn how good the York team is from some other, methods. For example, if there's any other club members or students in York, and if they have some, overlapping game with other clubs. And, so for this circumstance, we only know that York was quite strong in the Students' Nationals. Mm. But as we know, there are not totally 100% York University student, because Students' Nationals, you can invite some other universities around who cannot send the full team
okay.
to join the university a team to make a big one.
Okay.
So, so as you can tell now, it's Lancaster itself is very strong, and we have many players this year. And this is our first team, to be honest. And we have second team. Second team are more for beginners, but they are quite passionate about participating in this wonderful sport. And they are trying to, practicing. But again, as I said, York is so important, so we don't want to take the risk. But they still have the chance to join other, tournaments, which is suitable for that level.
Well, the play seems to have stopped. Is this halftime?
I think it's the halftime. And you can see, for example, in the near end, we have the York.
Yes, York in the white caps, and Lancaster over on the far side of the pool in the blue. They will be swapping ends.
Yes, they are swapping the end. And it seems like York have more things to talk about, because they are losing a lot of goals.
Yes, they've been taking a bit of a battering in this first half.
Yeah.
It seems to be 7-0 to Lancaster after the first 15 minutes.
Let's say we are expecting at least one goal from the beginning of the second part. And I hope the discussion of the strategies will work.
So a score update, we believe the score to be 8-0 to Lancaster at halftime. which, if they continue that form into the second half, would put them at 16-0. Obviously, York may front a little bit of a comeback and try and get back into the game. But this has been a really strong showing from a Lancaster side that went to Nationals this year, finishing 8th and 11th out of 14.
Wow.
Noah, you were there at Nationals this year. What did you make of the Lancaster performance?
So I was not playing, actually, but I saw some videos and the pictures. Again, I'm not really sure about the strategies from York side, but from Lancaster side, it's like we keep the shape very, very complete, or we close, like swimming to each other. We are trying to keep like a triangle, no matter what situation it is. So we can have a middle field, we can have a forward, we can have a defender, and we can keep that shape very closely. So whenever a forward trying to attack, they can have like some other teammates to be like aside. In their vision, they can see there are someone trying to get the puck. Mm-hmm. And when they're defending, they are also knowing, okay, because we are trying to keep that shape, we know even that player is not in our like view, we can still know there must be someone trying to be in that position to help defend. So that's, I think, the strategy Lancaster team is trying to practice. They just keep a very fixed kind of like shape, no matter it is in attacking mode or in defending mode, and they can just have a good connection with each other. And
in a lot of team sports, that good defensive structure is really important to try and stop the opposition from breaking you down. But to be honest, it's not something that Lancaster have really had to worry about very much, because they've had really strong offensive force. It's been all Lancaster through the whole first half.
Well, so it could be either the strategic issue, like the way they defend is something wrong, or it's just because Lancaster's forwards are too powerful. Mm-hmm. As I know, there are some like forwards, they swim so fast, they dive very fast, they have very, very good like forward pushing power, and it's very difficult for you to be in the floor of the pool to think about a lot of things at the same time. You have to hold your breath, mm-hmm. you have to look at how the counterpart is doing, you want to know where is your teammate, and you just you know, bring a lot of difficulties for the defenders to organize an effective way, you know, to block.
And it's into the second half now. We've started off with a quick Lancastrian attack, and it appears that they have scored straight away.
Yes.
Starting off the second half where they left off the first.
Although we have some difficulties that you can see in that side, in the left side, there are some battle there. Mm-hmm. But again, as I said, because Lancaster team forwards, they are so powerful, once they get the puck, they have lots of like strategies to apply for, you know, avoiding the lose of the mm-hmm. puck. For example, they have the fake move.
Yeah.
You see like they are trying to move the puck to the right side, but they will have like a fake move and immediately turn mm-hmm. the puck into their body and change it into the opposite position.
Mm. So it's being in the water and does that help or hinder your ability to turn quickly?
It's very challenging, and you need a lot of like exercise, and also turning to right and turning to left is mm-hmm. different, because most of people, they are right-handed, so it's very natural for them to, or it's very easy for them to turn like in the left side, because it's the way how the right-handed is good at. And again, I think we have another goal.
Yes, another goal for Lancaster there. Yes, it's been a really, really great discussion. Thanks very much for providing your insights. And we see Lancaster again going at them. I think that is double figures for Lancaster now, 10-0.
Wow.
Absolutely swarming the York goal as we head into the next point.
Okay, let's see. We can see in the middle field, people are trying to get the puck. And now York players are getting the puck, but just easily stolen by the Lancaster player. And they are trying to move to the other side to slow down the process of the attack. They are still trying to have a fight in the middle field, and it is quite effective so far.
Lancaster heading forward with the puck. It looks like it could be another goal for Lancaster here. But the ball's come.
There are lots of like players on the floating, and that means they have no idea where is the puck.
I mean, to be honest, Noah, neither do we. The puck has gone over into the far corner of the pool to where we are sitting, and there's
another goal
out over that, which means that the glare from the windows means we really can't see what's going on over there.
Very.
So
we have to say it again. Octopush is not very audience-friendly game because you know if you don't have the underwater camera. All the thing you can see is like people are floating, people are diving, people are moving in the water.
That being said, I hope you're enjoying our coverage and the insight that Noah's providing into the techniques and how we can get, how you can gain an advantage in this most unique of sports. If you're enjoying it on Roses Live or if you're listening on University Radio York or Bellrig FM, then make sure you leave us a message. You can do so on the URI website, uri.org.uk. Let us know if you're enjoying the streams. Let us know what you want to know. We're really enjoying providing a service that people wouldn't normally get because even Octopush, I think I'm right in saying, is not an Olympic sport. So I don't think... I think Rose is maybe the one chance that people get to watch Octopush and if they don't play, appreciate... the different challenges and different tactics that can go into the sport. So I think even if we're not able to provide the most descriptive audio commentary, it's really, really good that we've been able to give people a window.
If someone who has some experience of swimming and diving or have the experience of water polo or any other water sport or underwater sport, actually you can find a lot of like videos, either game videos or tutorial videos. And you can have a close look at what exactly going on under the water. And I do encourage some experienced swimmers to join this sport because it is becoming more and more popular here.
And even if it's difficult to watch from the sidelines, it's still very entertaining. There's lots of tight movements, lots of diving up and down in the water. Like it's a very entertaining sport to watch. And we've got the score now. The score is 14 to Lancaster, 0 to York.
Unfortunately.
So Lancaster have now matched their points total from the last Roses game with Octopush that was played all the way back in 2018, 5 years ago now. Yes. Noah, am I right in thinking you were there in Lancaster when Octopush was last played at Roses?
Yeah, it was in 2019. I think it was in York.
Apologies, my fact sheet is wrong.
Just before the COVID, right?
Yes.
And yeah, it is my first time actually joining the official Roses underwater game. Mm-hmm. And as I told you earlier,
unfortunately our information was wrong. It is 16-0 to Lancaster. Six.
We are trying to figure out how many goals 17. We have.
16-0. Our producer's doing an excellent job of non-verbal communication. And
sign language is used here.
It is 16-0 to Lancaster. Apologies for the confusion. But you are listening to the Octopush or the underwater hockey coming at you live from the York Sport Village. It is roughly 5 minutes to 2. And we've got about 5 minutes left to play of this second half.
Don't worry if you are supporting York because the fixture shows is like for this game they have no like points, so you can just totally enjoy the process of the game. Because last year when it was held in Lancaster, somehow York was unable to. to join the Roses 2022.
Yes, so we had to forfeit. York had to forfeit due to a lack of players last
year. So let's talk about the history. So last time before the pandemic, it was 2019 in York, and we beat York.
Yeah.
So we kept the trophy, and we've been keeping the trophy for years.
Yes.
So.
You're looking forward to keeping the trophy again one more for another year. We'll see. Maybe York can put together a legendary Octopush team for next season.
Highly possible. Yeah, yes, it's very likely.
16 we don't have Lancaster enough. With another run coming for Lancaster. This could be 17 now. Lancaster have
and
scored. It is 17-0 to Lancaster.
There's another interesting thing you can see is like. When we are thinking about how many people they are not in on the floor, as you can see, York players are more people floating. That means more Lancaster players are on the floor. They have more advantages because they are trying to connect each other. So yes, that could be one of the issue for York players to pay attention to.
Yeah, so we're seeing a six-side game of underwater hockey. Everyone, we got the York in the white hats, Lancaster in the blue hats.
Yes.
Each participant has a snorkel on with the tube coming out to the side so they can see in front of them. They are wearing a pair of flippers or fins to help them swim around the water. And in their right hand, it is gloved. And they have a bat, as you called it earlier.
Yes, that's the bat, yes.
To help them to knock the puck around. As we see Lancaster score
another
18th goal of
the
game.
Wow, that's very amazing. That's something that we really didn't expect because during the Students' Nationals, we have the game with York, and we think he's very, like,
what was the score
fair
at the
player.
Do you remember?
I can't remember, but it's like we won and we lose for each because we have like two games with York. So we think it could be like a fair player, fair side. But it turns out to be like, it's just like it's like a one side advantage.
What we're seeing a lot, and I've noticed, is we've got some people doing a flutter kick or freestyle kick to move away from the wall using their arms, and other people using dolphin kick to get away from the wall before diving down. What do you think is the inspiration behind choosing either of those?
It depends on the experience of the player. And for example, if you are in the position of forward, so no matter which way you dive, you swim, the major thing, the one thing you only consider about is how to get the puck first.
Yeah.
So some people are good at doing dolphin. Some people are doing good at doing like freestyle. So. It's just like, it depends on the individual difference. In our team, we have both types, actually. And also, it turns out to be like, it is relevant to the, with the game going. Sometimes you are too tired to use one of those. You will choose to swim and dive in another way. But it seems like Lancaster is very powerful all the time.
Yes, Lancaster are always getting to the puck first.
Yes.
They are consistently breaking through the York defense. You spoke a lot about how you need good defensive structure to stop the attacks, but Lancaster are relentless. And you can see a player going around the outside there using dolphin kick.
They're trying to defend
all
it.
All the way around to
but
the right.
Unfortunately, it's too fast to get it, to block it. So was there's that, another goal.
That was another goal, and I think that was one of the most impressive goals we've seen, because they came right around wide the right-hand side, wide along the
which
touch
means
line,
there's almost no block under the water.
Yeah, and the York, he just got around the York block in behind them
here
and
we
scored
go again.
Really, really well. Lancaster showing their class.
Wow, that's amazing.
And to be clear, the score is 19-0. Lancaster could get to 20-0 with one more goal, and it's close enough to the end. It's pretty close to the end of the game, but it could still be achieved. Lancaster will be pushing for it because this is a rout already.
We are really expecting York at least having a goal to show their spirit, but as you can see, we have Lancaster have more effective. Is this a foul or is the time's up?
The referee has put up a T.
Okay, so
that's
the end of the game. Congratulations to Lancaster Octopush Club.
And they give each team 3 cheers for goodwill. And that will be the points for Lancaster. Round of applause from the benches, from the balcony.
Huge congratulations
for an
to Lancaster.
Game of Octopush.
And also, we will also say that it's well done for York players because they can, as we can see, they try their best to block under the water and they're trying to show their different strategies, trying to show their different techniques to go against Lancaster players. Just because Lancaster's players are more powerful and they have more efficient team organization. Mm-hmm. So, yes, that's the end of this interesting game.
So this game we've seen has finished 21-0 to Lancaster. An incredible game. Thank you very much for joining us for the Octopush.
Thank you for having me.
I don't believe there's any more Octopush. That was the game, right?
Yes, that's very
amazing. Good stuff. Just good to make sure we got clear lines of communication. Thank you very much for joining us here on the Octopush. Whether you've been listening on uy.org.uk or on Bailrig FM or joining us on Roses Live with the visuals.
Stay tuned.
Make sure you tune into any of the variety of other sports we've got going on right now. We have water polo coming up very soon from the pool, so we're not done here at York Sport Village. Make sure you tune back in for the water polo coming very, very soon. For now, thank you very much for watching or listening. Thank you to Noah for joining
us.
This has been the Octopush. It is Lancaster 21, York 0.